What's past is prologue, nigga. Let me launch into this rhyme before I space out as the weed travels through the pathways of my brain. My cranium, nigga, is titanium, nigga, a fortress. Allow me to be your Greek chorus, your travel guide to the other side of the city. Trust me, bitch, this shit ain't pretty. These are bloodstained streets where niggas be dropping like fruit flies. Allow me to fill you in on the deets. Don't worry, I'ma keep it real nice and neat. The name is Jean-Baptiste Delacroix. That's Francais for up the cross. Yeah, you could bet I'm the illest motherfucker you'll come across. Bed Stuy, Brooklyn, is the setting of our tale, where another young nigga was slain. Shot down on the stained concrete where fresh blood runs deep, a tragedy spilling on the streets for everybody to see. And ye gathered here to see the spectacle, gawk at the remains, and then politely leave. Y'all are so amenable. But wait! What's there around the corner, you ask? Just another piggy lying in wait, ready for niggas to take the bait. It's a fishing expedition, an entire country living in division, black, white. Our segregation is tradition, but gentrification is the new apartheid, nigga. Step aside, let these whites in, cause social mobility ain't a sin unless you got that dark skin, that shaded pigment. This ain't no figment of my imagination. This is the fragmentation, institutionalization of a nation, but let's not change the conversation. The nigga they shot right there. Approximately 12 hours ago. He wasn't no John Doe, he had a name, yo. Forrest Winthrop was the unidentified black male. Forrest Winthrop was the unidentified black male. Let me tell you his story before this shit gets stale, before another young black boy drops at the hands of a stupid, pale-faced motherfucking cop. Forrest was a youngin, no more than 19. Dark skin, tall, lean, mean, fight machine. But on this night, he couldn't put up no fight. He couldn't defend himself. He had ended a battle he wasn't gonna win. When Forrest found himself in front of a trigger, he was just another wrong place, wrong time nigga. What's past is prologue, nigga. Jean-Baptiste be like, fuck the police. How you supposed to win when you don't know the rules? They don't teach this shit in schools. These motherfuckers are stealing our family jewels, our sons and fathers. Nigga, you better recognize they changing history. An entire generation of black men who were never allowed to be. Yo, they might have stopped hanging us from trees, but a century later, they still cutting black people at the knees. That's why we got a band like a pack of thieves. Creep through the night to send these motherfucking pigs back to their motherfucking slaughter. These words, niggas, this here the key to get me off of the street, to collect my fees, get a taste that'll widen my waist. A piece of that guap, that cheddar, that mail. Don't you kidnap my dreams. Don't you tell me, pull myself up by my bootstraps. Fuck that. I got entitlement, just like Whitey. You got two choices. Either give me my share of the bounty, or I steal the food right out of your mouth, proudly. This past is prologue, nigga.
la croix!
Look who it is, back from the dead. Where you been, nigga?
Just got back from London.
London? Fuck you doing there?
My roommate was from there.
Your roommate?
Yeah, Augustus. He invited me for the summer. His family lives in London.
Well, it ain't like summer's over. She going back here then?
My mom's been begging me to see her. Only here through the weekend. School starts on Tuesday.
Glad we can make your itinerary, nigga. What was London like?
You have to go. The buildings, they've been there since like the beginning of time. It's like this place where the past and the present meets. Like, I catch myself thinking, right here in this same place, an infinite number of people have stood.
So that's where you've been this whole time?
Well, at first I took summer classes, but then I was there.
Now you're here.
Everything looks the same.
Does it?
I knew I was gonna catch you out here.
You know this my stoop, nigga. You know where to find me.
You always very reliable.
Nigga, I'm still reliable.
No thanks. What you been up to?
Same old, same old.
Hey, you ever go back to school?
You know, I never thought I was gonna see you again. Just thought you was gonna become some nigga I used to know.
Tried to call you a couple times.
Nigga, it's my phone.
What?
My phone. I didn't get your calls because of my phone.
What kind
of
phone do you have?
Yeah. They brought this shit over with Christopher Columbus, my nigga.
Yeah.
Yeah. Pilgrims took one look at me and said, nigga, you take this. We ain't got no more use for it. Right before they went off and killed the Indians and shit.
You're not supposed to call them that, actually. It's not proper nomenclature.
Nomen what?
Nomenclature. It's what you're supposed to call people. They're not Indians anymore. They're Native Americans.
But niggas are still niggers, right?
Mm. Is Aisha around?
Nigga, she at work. Adriana back, she been here the whole summer.
Oh, good.
Hope we ain't keeping you from bigger and better things.
What are you talking about?
Oh, you ain't coming home. That's why you got that little ass bag. You just visited.
Augustus, let me use his stuff.
I don't want to hear about your new white friends.
Augustus is black. They make black people in England, too. Look, you ever go back to school, get your GED?
Nah, nigga, why you keep asking?
I thought by now you would
what?
Put your life back together.
Oh, I ain't know it was ever apart.
Yeah, I thought you'd be happy to see me.
I don't have the capacity to feel that right now.
I have a right to be here.
Yes, nigga, you do.
Then why you acting like I'm not welcome?
Does this look like a destination to you?
You know, I've missed you a lot.
Yeah, Calvin, I've done nothing but think of you this past year.
I could never not come back.
You say that now, but when you was heading off to college last year with all your shit packed, you and your mama filled up that rental car with your whole fucking life. Not once did you look back, nigga. You packed your shit, your mom's turned on the car, and you drove off like we were shadows blocking you from the light. We all stood on this fucking stoop, Calvin, and you never turned your head.
I turned back and waved at all of you.
Nigga, your head was looking nowhere before.
You don't know me anymore.
Oh, that's what you come to
talk
about.
Look, sorry you didn't go back to school.
Yeah, you're sorry.
You were supposed to get your GED. The plan was to get out of here this year. If you need help, I know somebody. Augustus.
Hey, yo, Calvin, you mention that motherfucker's name one more time? I swear to God.
Yeah, I better get inside.
You wait, nigga. Well, I know. Spent 3 months. But still, you don't want to talk about Forrest. Huh? Yes, it's old news by now. You just want to go on about your new friends, new life, new everything. You ain't got shit to say about what the fuck happened to Forrest, huh? Answer me, motherfucker! You work the morning shift today.
You know that fat bitch, Portia? Victoria's mess of a child? The one who's always walking around in those pink juicy couture sweatsuits looking like a overweight crayon? Well, she finally popped out her kid and I got her shifts. Nigga, my feet are barking like a motherfucker. And since Portia's out, I have to listen to Sierra all day long, nigga. I gotta pretend like I give a shit when she's talking and this bitch goes on and on, filling the air while her hot, stank-ass breath talking about nothing. 10 hours today, and ain't shit coming to mouth that I need to, and shit she added to the world by opening her fat fucking mouth.
What's she talking about this time?
Sierra lucky she the manager, not no one would listen to her ass. She coming today and she talk about her raggedy ass Jamaican piece of shit husband. This motherfucker dark as night. You ever heard of a blurple nigga? A motherfucker so damn dark he purple, with fucking glow-in-the-dark teeth. And she talking about how she gotta look good for her man, and this bitch walks in with a Diana Ross fro out to here, Some fuchsia dress she had taped on herself and Claire Hills. And you know what they say about them Claire Hills, nigga. And she like, ain't I fine, Aisha? Ain't I fine? That nigga gonna want some of this. Ain't I right, boo? And I'm like, Sierra, girl, you need to dress for the body that you have, not the body that you want, bitch. And she's still going on and on about her husband, who is apparently fucking some hood right out in Brownsville. And I'm like, girl, give it a week and she might get shot anyway.
Yo, I seen her hair today. You think that's all a real hair?
Yeah, nigga, she really bought it all by herself. That bitch walked around the entire fucking store making sure everybody saw her. Thinking that dressing like a 99 cent hoe is gonna fix everything. Nigga, she ain't doing shit but putting a band-aid on it. And every day, she walk in with a new set of hair, each one more tough than the last. Last week, she gave a weave a haircut. Like, for real, nigga, she really did. She said she couldn't take it because of heat, so she took some scissors and started snipping off ends in the back. Being like, Aisha, it's too damn hot for this shit. And I'm like, you couldn't have waited until the morning? And she says she's looking out for me by giving me these extra shifts now and then, but every time I get my check, I'm like, where you was looking, bitch? Because there ain't shit here. I'm going blind from looking at all this motherfucking nothingness. And she got a car. Shit, I could use a car. She never asked to work and back, and she live a fucking few blocks from me. You think she owes me a ride? You think I like carrying Sebastian up and down again? I'm fucking wearing out my back. 20 years old, going on 85, nigga, that's how you feel. That's how you fucking feel.
Yo, the money's coming in. You're going to see it in your checks real soon. It don't work that fast.
Nigga, how you know how it works? You ain't got no job.
Be lucky. Be lucky you getting the mouths.
Too bad I got to work them. I am so fucking tired. I got a headache. So is my damn feet feel like they about to give out.
You eat something? Don't tell me it's because you don't got no food. You know my mom's always take care of you.
You don't gotta tell me, nigga. Your mom is a saint. All that Haitian food she be feeding Sebastian, my little boy don't even want regular food no more. His eyes get all wide and shit at the sight of rice and beans. Fat as a motherfucker. Where's my son?
With my mom's upstairs watching TV.
Was he good today? Did he do anything interesting?
Yeah, the little nigga five, he live in front of the television. He eat, shit, laugh, sleep in the day.
Nigga, shut up. I will not have you disrespecting my child. Don't make me regret making you his godfather. He's a sweet boy. I know you're only five, but he got a good soul. And he's smart, too. Memorizes commercials and sings them back to me. If only he get out of them damn diapers.
He's still wearing the bed.
Yo, I've been telling him I'm going to cut off all his liquids because he don't stop. But he ain't listening to me. He just go off into that far-off place of his. Yo, man, but between me and you, one day, Sebastian gonna take care of all of us. Just like Forrest was supposed to. Sebastian is always telling me how much he missed me. It's always the first thing he say to me. He wraps his little chubby arms around my neck, squeezes me tight, whispers into my ear, Mama, you don't know how much I missed you today. And then he steps back and he brings his arms out like he's trying to show me. I never know what to say to that.
Why don't you tell him that you missed him too?
If I missed him so much in mine, I with him all the time.
You can't quit your job, Aisha.
Nigga, did I say that? Did you hear those words come out of my mouth?
The way you're complaining sounds like you're getting ready to leave.
I can't fucking complain? Shit, can I air this out? Tired of people telling me I should feel. Yo, don't tell me that I can't complain. Would you want me to go back to crying all the time? Would that be better? Nigga, why don't we do this? Why don't y'all all get together and then tell me what I should do and how I should run my life? Because I'm sick of this inconsistent bullshit. Aisha, you need to get off your ass and get a job. You got a baby support. No, what you need to do is stay at home with your baby. Sit around collecting government checks. It's your right, girl. Aisha, you can't keep crying all the time. You got to wear this memory. Aisha, why are you not crying? Don't you miss him? Mm-hmm. Aisha, it's been 3 months. I don't want to hear you complaining. You need to get over that, nigga. Aisha, do this. Aisha, do that. Aisha, do this. Aisha, do that. Aisha, Aisha, Aisha. Just let me be.
Why don't you ask your moms to help out? I don't know, man. She's always nice to me. You and Adriana always seem like you're talking about someone else.
You think that godless woman cares about me or anyone else other than herself? The only thing she gives a shit about is the first of the month, that married dick she getting, and keeping up a bullshit Bible thumping act. It ain't like my name's on any of them checks anyway.
But go get your name on some checks. It ain't that hard, and you got good reason.
I'ma do what I need to do for myself, okay? Not sit around with my hand out when I could be busy getting me my own. Because the minute you start taking their money, nigga, you letting yourself be owned. I'ma put this shit back together myself. What I'ma do is I'ma go buy me some of that Dr. Show shit, at the 99 cent store, put that shit in my sneakers, take a couple of leave with me to work, and keep it moving, okay?
Okay.
Stop giving advice. You're in no position to do so. Yeah. And stop smoking that shit. You're gonna get it all over me, and I'm gonna give it to Sebastian.
You're not doing anything right, buddy.
Why don't you go fuck someone? Get yourself a girl, nigga. What about Adriana? Nigga. Do you think you could get anything past me? I see the way you be looking at her like she the last fucking Coca-Cola in the desert.
She different now.
Girl is paranoid. Fucking lost the mind, but I don't mean she ain't cute. You know she tried to kill herself when she was back to school.
What?
She don't know this, but a couple of months ago I called her phone, but some other girl answered, said that she was in a hospital, said that she was her roommate, she was the one who found her. Said she drank some lithium, whatever the fuck that is, and slit her wrist.
Lithium.
My sister is always looking for the easy way out. Listen, my mama don't even know, and you cannot tell Adriana I told you. It's hard enough living with her as is. You don't see me out here trying to kill myself, and I'm like, huh, I got plenty of reasons. Her and Forrest weren't even all that close. In fact, remember when I got pregnant, she stopped seeing
me all
the time. I
think she got that PTSD shit.
How could she get that shit? She wasn't even there. She wasn't involved. She didn't have nothing happen to
her. That's not
her.
How that shit works.
She should have been running like a fucking crackhead.
I should.
Like he was some Kenyan motherfucker training for a marathon.
I should, please.
It was 3 o'clock in the morning, nigga. I know I told him to hurry, but nobody told him to run. You know we can't be running like that. That nigga knew that, too.
I should.
Motherfucker knew I needed them diapers that whole day. It ain't like it's news. Sebastian needs diapers. Point blank. But no, does this boy go out and do what he's told me he's supposed to? Motherfucker always left everything for the last minute. You know, when I got when I was giving birth, that nigga ran from the hospital, jumped on a bus, and came all the way back here because he forgot his camera. Motherfucker almost missed
it too. Please.
If I'm going to talk about him, I'm going to talk about him whichever way I want. It don't make me any less sad to think of him as he really was. There's a lot of shit about Forrest you don't know. He should have been running.
I know.
Now I got a son without a father. That nigga live in the South a whole year. Then he comes home, spends one night here, and bam! We just gonna have to keep it moving. I'm gonna keep my job, and you gonna get yourself a job. You make it to that job fair?
Saw something at Barclays Center. They have an interview tomorrow.
All right, so when you starting?
I don't know. I might not go.
Then, nigga, why did you tell me? I swear I don't understand you sometimes.
Because I want you to know I am looking. I am trying.
You ain't trying hard enough. Here's what you're going to do. You're going to get up real early in the morning tomorrow. You're going to put yourself on a suit.
I should.
You're going to slip into your leather shoes, and you're going to get yourself this job, nigga. A diploma ain't everything. As long as you look the part, they ain't got to look at you for too long. And if you need to get the wrinkles out of that suit, you just turn on the shower, you let the bathroom fill up with steam, you hang your little suit on a tie rack, and you smooth out the wrinkles with your hands. And you got to shine on shoes. I haven't told you this, but lately, you've been looking pretty dusty, nigga. So, make sure you take a shower beforehand, that way your skin looks all fresh and shit. Put on some lotion, and don't be stingy with it now. And you got to smooth out this nappy ass bro of yours. I don't understand why you can't do that.
You're not listening to me.
You gonna get yourself this job, nigga. I don't care what the fuck you gotta do. Come tomorrow afternoon, you better be employed. Do you hear me? You better be employed.
Not going.
Why not?
Because I don't want to be a janitor, okay? I'm a storyteller. That's my job. I'm gonna be a rapper one day. You should hear some of the shit I write.
Nigga, I thought we were talking seriously. Because you talking like you got options and choices. Nigga, you ain't window shopping. Stop being a little boy, sitting in your little stoop, reading your little book. Get the fuck up. Be a man. Contribute. Become a productive member of society, nigga. Stop smoking this shit. It is fucking with your brain because you don't seem to be living in reality. You know, Forrest was a man. He took care of his shit. And you? You ain't nothing but a child holding on your little dream, looking up at everybody else like we supposed to be proud of you. Nigga,
and what, and where he at right now? Huh? Where's Forrest?
You think you're above being a janitor? You ain't worth shit, nigga. Shit. Where you going? Jean-Baptiste.
What's wrong?
Stop.
Why?
They watching me.
Missed you?
Thought you were never gonna come back.
Why does everyone keep saying that?
You've been gone a very long time, Calvin.
I had school, then I went to London, I just got back.
Yeah? How was it?
It was... It wasn't home.
Oh, and you love being home, right? That's why your ass haven't been here in over a year, because you love it here.
Fine. I'll go. Y'all obviously don't want me here, so I'm gonna go, okay?
I'm just tired. Where did you go, Calvin? Why weren't you here?
Does it matter that I'm here now?
Nope.
Do you want me to leave?
Nope.
Well, what do you want then?
What?
I said, what do you want?
You know, you're the first person to ask me that in a really long time.
Yeah?
Can you say it again? Can you say those words again?
What? You.
You know, if you couldn't come back soon for me, you should have at least come back for Forrest. You were still his friend.
You know, he knew.
If Forrest knew we was messing around, he would have ripped the skin right off of my body. And after he was done with me, it would have been you on the news. He didn't know shit.
Then I guess it didn't feel right.
Which part, Calvin?
Even though I was in London, I still kept up.
Mm.
I read articles about him, saw him on the news a couple of times. My mother called me, told me what was happening.
Mm. I bet they made a real interesting conversation with your new friends.
Never came up.
Mm-hmm.
Look, they kept showing the same picture over and over again. You know which one I'm talking about?
Yo, I told Antoinette we need to get a proper picture of your son because it's the picture that everybody gonna know him from. What does this bitch ass mother do? She picks the picture from Auntie Beverly's Christmas extravaganza.
I know, I recognize
it. I begged Antoinette to give him a different picture. Why don't we use one of his football pictures? Why don't we use his graduation picture? He looks so handsome, so strong. But no, she picks the Christmas picture where he's standing in front of a tree like a grinning idiot, cheesing our heart and shit. Like it was the first fucking Christmas and Jesus Christ himself is here. He looked like a grown-ass man in his football pictures. You could see all of him, his muscles and his strength. No, she say he looked like fucking King Kong. We can't have people be afraid of him, Aisha. So this stubborn bitch picks a picture where he looked like a child, and because of the flash, that nigga looked three shades lighter. Better make people feel real sad to see a little boy get killed.
I haven't seen that, Antoinette.
And you ain't gonna. She gone. Bitch needed a reason to hit the pipe, and now she got one. Once the cameras went away and everybody stopped watching her, she became the crackhead that she always wanted to be. She only bring a forest when she wants something. But everybody thinks she a saint, like she earned something for living through this shit. Patron saint of bullshit. That's what she is. For $5, she put on a real good show. And for 10, she make you think it's real. Only time I see her now is when she running down the street to get her medicine. Panting and sweating and heaving like a runaway slave. Asking me when is she gonna see Sebastian. Bitch! As far as he know, he ain't got no grandparents. He ain't got no one else.
He got you.
My little boy was doing so well. He had a father. About here? Yeah, well, we got his pictures.
I hate that picture. When I saw it on the news, I thought you were trying to send me a message.
I would not have picked that picture. You know that shit.
I've been reliving that night for a year now.
Really? Because the last time I checked, Columbia's just a train ride away. You could have did more than live it.
You think it was easy for me? Coming from here and going there, I'm average now. But when I was living in the library and drowning myself in homework and stressing over grades, I'd stop. And I would think about that night, those months.
I would have forgotten all about that night if it hadn't been for that picture. Now all I see is forest.
Girl, don't you tell me you don't remember. I took that picture. You were out of the frame by maybe an inch, and Forrest was frozen still while you were off to the side watching him, because you were always off to the side
Stop.
When he was around.
Your pretty words ain't gonna pay my bills.
You keep acting like things were perfect. Oh, Are you now just remembering things your way?
Shit made sense. Forrest had a football scholarship to Florida State. There was our way out. Then he was going to play for their team. Then he was going to get drafted to the NFL. And then he was going to be the richest nigga to come out of here since Jay-Z. Me and Sebastian was just doing our time, waiting for Forrest to come back and put the shit in motion, take us the fuck out of here.
So you wanted to be his trophy?
Somebody got to be in his own shit. Why not me? Lord knows every NFL player need a pretty wife. So the baby came early. That's fine. You were a family. You had me for what? 6 months? He had me for 5 years. And if he hadn't been so damn stupid, none of this shit would have happened. Oh, I gotta work. And honey, ugh, was not made for working.
You can't blame him for what happened.
So are you defending him? Because just a minute ago, you were saying that he pushed me off to the background, saying he was using me. So which is it? Pick a fucking side, Talon. Pick a side. You know if he hadn't been running that night, he would still be here. But he was running, and he was
running, and he
ran himself to death.
You like all those white people who will think we bring this shit on to ourselves? Like, you're angry with him, but that doesn't make this his fault.
You just like John Baptiste. You think we living in a world where we got options and choices. What's the ugly fucking truth? We gotta be a certain kind of people. We gotta act a particular way. We gotta do the shit that they tell us to do.
Who was holding the gun? Who was holding the gun, Aisha? Was it Forrest?
Well, maybe the gun wouldn't have came out if he didn't give him a reason.
And maybe he shouldn't have been born. Maybe he shouldn't have existed. Maybe none of us should exist. Maybe we should just go back to being in chains and shackles, because apparently that was much easier for everyone. But now the shackles are invisible, but the imprisonment is still the same. Oh, he was running. Oh, he was wearing a hoodie. Oh, no, his music was too loud. How dare he? Look, there's a war going on, Aisha. And Forrest was a casualty, not a cause. And you cannot blame him for what happened. I won't let you do that to yourself.
Whatever, Calvin, you know everything.
Was any of it real? Are you just trying to hurt him?
It was. But lucky for you, right? Now you got me, and you don't ever have to worry about him coming after you. This all worked out great for you.
And I'm here for you. Take the night off.
Calvin.
Come on, Aisha, like, do something for yourself for once. Who's watching Sebastian?
Miss Delacroix.
And she don't know you're back yet. Look, let me take care of you. Just for the night, come on. Aisha.
But we just playing house. I ain't got no more room.
You know
don't
you shouldn't live.
Do that, okay? Don't do that!
Sorry! Still shouldn't be smoking that shit.
They about to legalize it anyway. Who gives a shit? Don't sneak up on me like that. Don't you ever sneak
got
up.
Got it.
Why you up so early?
Still on London time.
Right. How was it?
Pretty good.
All the museums are free, right?
Yeah, but they close like mad early, like 5 p.m. I was like, who's the target demographic here?
Tourists and the unemployed.
Basically.
You just stay in London or you go anywhere else?
I took a day trip down to Stonehenge.
Really?
I know I'm supposed to have something profound to say about it, but it's just a bunch of rocks. That they have no meaning doesn't take away from their ordinariness, but I pretended to be in awe just like everybody else, but really, I was so bored.
Bored on vacation.
I was just visiting my roommate. He's from there.
Bet you're friends with all kinds of posh kids at Columbia.
Augustus is black.
Dear God, Augustus? Still though, swimming through all that privilege, bet you're knee-deep in preeminent scholars and future politicians named Francis and Preston and Edmund and Frederick.
I like it. And didn't you apply to Columbia?
Nope. Started my application but couldn't really turn because Barack Obama went there to 500 words.
NYU's not so bad.
Thanks, Calvin. Now I can move on with my life.
Just saying.
I thought you had sworn this place off, that you were never ever coming back here.
Yeah, you did.
I ain't have a choice. My roommate was a miserable cunt.
I'm sorry.
Freshman year is supposed to suck, but NYU takes it to new levels. These kids' entitlement is only surpassed by their apathy. And when they finally take the silver spoon out of their mouth, bullshit just comes pouring out.
You should transfer there.
Please. A degree from there and I'm set.
What are you doing up so early?
Can't sleep.
You should take something then.
I'm not taking any fucking medication.
You know why you can't sleep?
I have dreams about them. Nightmares, actually. It's always the same thing. It's dark. The street lights have burnt out. I'm all alone and it's eerie out. Like, horror movie eerie. Here I am standing over him, but it's not him. It's some vague, faceless figure labeled Forrest by my fucked up brain, and this crimson color blood drips off my palms and down my arms, and I'm yelling at him to wake up, wake the fuck up, because there's this feeling that someone is coming after us. A gust of wind pours in, almost knocking me over, then suddenly my hand feels very, very heavy. I look over and there's a gun in it. The biggest, most powerful gun I've ever seen. And it feels warm. No, hot. Then I realized I killed him. I killed Forrest. Then I wake up, come out here, smoke. 3 months in the same dream. Sometimes he's still alive, other times it's morning and not night. Usually when I wake up, I get Sebastian out of his crib and I lay him next to me and I watch him sleep, because if he's okay, I'm okay, you know? And he's okay. He's the most okay out of all of us.
Does Aisha know about the dream?
Obviously. I told her and my mother. They both looked at me like I'm some lunatic.
Well, it is a weird dream. You should go see a therapist. They could prescribe you something. Augustus takes Lunesta.
Does he?
Look, I'm sure the dream will go away eventually. You just gotta remember that it's not real. That it only matters if you assign meaning to it. You really ought to go see a doctor or something.
Jesus, Calvin. You always have a fucking solution for everything. You should transfer. You should take something. You should see someone. Well, you should go fuck yourself. You know everything. Don't think you're hot shit when you're really just feeling some diversity quota, you smug bastard. You have a fucking clue what it's like. You just got here and lived through it. Everyone's moved on. It's almost fall. That shit happened in the summer. Fuck Forrest, right? He's old news. Now we got another boy to cry over. Every month there's a different one. How would they ever keep up with us? Fuck you, Calvin. Fuck you. You gonna fuck me too? Isn't that how you comfort people?
I don't know what you're talking about.
I'm in the next room, fuckface.
I'm gonna go. I'm heading to the bodega, okay? You want something? I thought I might buy Aisha and Sebastian some breakfast, and I can get you anything. Anything you want.
Sebastian's still got a father, Calvin. He may be dead, but he already has one. Nobody, till somebody kills you. You're nobody, till somebody kills you. I don't want to die. Hey!
You in a good mood?
Damn, nigga, you styling. Where you going?
You wanna go get some girls? You wanna come?
At this hour?
What if I told you I was all dressed up for you?
Mm-hmm. Now you know I don't need much to get my pussy wet. Nah, I'm just fucking with you. But really, it's early as fuck. What shenanigans are you up to?
You and your words.
No, you know what that means. I saw it. Now, I know it ain't Calvin because, well, you can't hear Reed exactly. And it ain't Aisha because last time that bitch read, we had a white president. And it ain't mine because I already read this, but I never bought a copy. And Sebastian may show proficiency in his communication skills, but nothing up to the level of James Joyce. So, it must be yours. This is what you've been reading? Jean-Baptiste.
What? It's just a book.
I can't believe you're reading Dubliners. You know how many white people haven't read this? So proud of you.
I found it by the sidewalk one day. I like it.
What do you like about it?
I don't know. It just makes me think of all those people living in one place. I know he calls it Dublin, but it could be anywhere. Where you live is who you are, but who you are is where you live. Mm. I don't know if that made any sense.
It did.
I like the one about the two guys.
Two gallants. Experience had embittered his heart against the world, but all hope had not left him. That's my favorite line. When we read this in class, it didn't mean much to me, but when I found it out here...
Well, I can read.
Yes, you can. Where are you going? Good luck.
Wait, what?
It's a concept album. Mm-hmm. It's supposed to make niggas uncomfortable.
Right.
See, I got all this shit planned out. I do like most of the writing in my head, like when I'm walking around and shit.
Right.
So all I gotta do is sit down and write it out. Adriana, are you even listening to me?
What's your rap name? Don't tell me you ain't got one. That's step number one, nigga.
Delacroix. D-E-L-A-C-R-O-I-X. You know, with the French pronunciation, Delacroix.
You don't have to spell it out for me. It's your fucking last name. Oh, I didn't mean it like that. It's a good name. You done good, my brother.
What's so funny?
Good luck getting white folks to pronounce that shit correctly.
Well, we got them to pronounce Barack Obama correctly, so.
You know what?
What, girl?
Between you, me, and Dee, I hate white people. I really do.
Yeah?
I hate white people. I hate white people, fool. This how fucked up white people are, okay? These motherfuckers travel halfway across the world, raped and pillaged everything in their sight, destroyed the homes of the natives, displaced entire civilizations just to get their hands on some motherfucking spices. And these motherfuckers don't even have the decency to put that shit in their food. You ever taste white people's food? Bland as fuck and it tastes like nothing. I went over to some white girl's apartment for Thanksgiving. Halfway through my meal, I was like, okay, when are y'all gonna bring out the real food? Cause I can keep eating this shit, but I'm still hungry. You got motherfuckers like Paula Deen who wanna take credit for the shit that we make. This bitch acting like she invented soul food. And being all shocked and shit when she openly admits that the word nigger occasionally slips off her tongue like it's the fucking butter she shoves down her throat. Taking credit for our food, bitch, please. White people always want to take credit from us. You know where soul food comes from? I'm talking origins, not like what supermarket or your mom's recipe, nigga. I'm talking Genesis.
Nah, where?
Scraps.
Huh?
Nigga, from slavery. You see, the masters used to keep the best of the best to themselves. All the ham, all the pork roast, whatever goodness came out of the animals they slaughtered in the ground, they defiled, they kept to themselves. Greedy and considerate motherfuckers they were. And they gave us, the slaves I mean, the scraps. The leftovers, the undesirable parts of the meat, the shit that they was gonna throw out, but stopped and said, you know what? Let's give this to them. We ain't gonna use it. And even after slavery, years later, broke ass niggas could only afford this kind of shit. So the tradition continued. As usual, we may do with what everybody else considered garbage, insignificant, unwanted, scraps. It wasn't about food. That came later. The art of it all. But in its origin, it was about survival, nigga. Survival.
So, from scraps,
we made soul food. I hate white people. Not all the time, but sometimes.
Hell, they run the world.
Let them have it. This world ain't shit. Play me something upbeat. Set the mood, my nigga. Set the mood. Oh, shit. Haven't heard this song in a minute. Remember Forrest used to play this shit out? Played it like it just came out.
Uh-huh.
Played it like he owned the damn shit.
Uh-huh, for sure.
Ah, look who it is. Benedict Arnold. Shout
out to you. Get the fucking radio right here. Yo. Hold up. Yo, turn this shit up. I fucking
You better run and tell everybody. Let's rock, let's rock.
Come at me.
No.
Come at me.
Oh, come back!
No, officer, there's no problem here.
Why is he bleeding?
No, we were just messing around. A game that got out of hand, right?
Yeah, that's right.
They're making complaints about her. What is wrong with her?
She's got asthma, sir. Real bad.
It's okay. Just a game.
So?
Excuse me?
It's a Saturday night. I think we're entitled to some noise.
Okay. Let me see some ID from all of you. I need to see some ID. Now. Okay, what about you?
What about me?
You need to produce some identification, it's the law.
Aisha.
I don't gotta do shit.
Just keep the noise down, okay? Keep the noise down. The other people live here, understood?
Yes, sir. Absolutely, officer.
Are you okay?
Listen, I know about a couple months ago. I know that you have tried to.
Don't worry, Aisha. I'll always be the crazy one, so you'll always look better than me.
I'm sorry.
Step aside the gate. Step aside the gate.
Can I go?
You need to carry ID on you at all times.
Aisha, you still out here?
Calvin, go back inside.
Hey, good evening, officer. We turned off the noise just like you asked.
Back inside, sir.
Look, you were right, officer. There are other people in this neighborhood that should be taken
Calvin,
into consideration.
I can handle
myself. And so we all went inside, and now it's quiet out. Can you just let her go?
Stand back. Sir.
But we gave you what you asked for. Now all I'm asking is that you just please let her go.
Signal 30.
No, there's no need for that. All I'm asking is that you just please let her go. Look, we've done nothing wrong. In fact, if you let her go, she'll go back inside and she'll get her ID, right? Aisha? Officer, objectively speaking, we've done nothing wrong.
Stand
we gave you silence.
Stop moving! Stop moving! Stop resisting! Make it worse! Get up!
to you. Bible says he will wipe away every tear from their eyes, and there will be no more death or mourning or crying or pain, for the old order of things has passed away. Today we gather here to mourn our dearly beloved sister Adriana Douglas, our dear sister who has died far too young, but the Lord has called her away. Children, we cover you with prayers. Children, let them clothe you during these dark and perilous times. Let them guide you to a better future. For the Bible says, blessed are they that mourn, for they will be comforted. And lest we forget, it was a mere 3 years ago that this family gathered here in this very church to mourn our dear Forrest Winthrop. Our beloved rising star, Forrest Winthrop. Death has a way of making us reckon with all things past.
Sebastian, pay attention. Sebastian, don't make me repeat myself. Wipe that look off of your face. Don't you close your eyes. Don't you go off into that far off place. Sebastian, people are watching.
Black suits cling to me like mosquitoes in the summertime, sucking on my blood. Suckers are for after dinner time. Will there be dinner there tonight? I know this place. I've been here before. Never in the daytime. Never under watching eyes. I wonder when I learned this. Ah! I heard you the first time, okay? I heard you when I was 5, okay? When I was 6, okay? I heard you when I was 7, okay? I heard you. Over the TVs, over like when my mama's cries, running with my uncle's sighs. When my auntie was alive in the daytime, in the summertime, in my neckties, in my suits, in my dress shoes. You're the loudest. But I'm 8 now. Grown. Big boy. And I would please like for you to stop growling. Stop growling. Stop growling. You hear me? It's distracted and painful.
It's not your stomach that's growling.
Then what could it be? Because we got food in the house, but I can eat and I can eat, but I still hear that growling like a thunderbolt in my belly or an earthquake through my bones.
Those aren't hunger pains, Sebastian.
You know who never went hungry? My daddy. The great almighty Forrest Winthrop was born from an electrical outage in Kings County Hospital, and his first breath turned the lights back on. And when his foot first made contact with the world, the earth trembled when it
started. Tremble.
My daddy was gonna buy me and my mama a house in a suburban neighborhood. So far up on the hill, your neck was snapping.
Snappity, 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 snap.
My daddy was gonna start the Forrest Winthrop School for Black Boys Who Make It to Manhood. My daddy was gonna be a football star. The richest nigga to come out of here since Jay-Z.
Dollar bills, y'all!
So says mama. But mama will say anything to get me to stop crying. She'll say anything to get me to stop questioning. Mama says I'm an open sore and the world keeps pouring salt into me.
So?
She could be lying or shoo me away like a fly or a pest. You know what? Mama is lying. She lies all the time. For all we know, who knows where Sebastian is?
You mean daddy.
That's what I said. For all we know, my daddy isn't even dead. He's walking around in New Jersey with some other family being somebody else's dad. Or he wasn't even my daddy to begin with, and my real daddy just isn't around.
You know what happened to daddy.
Or his window could be anybody for all we know. Are you my daddy? Huh?
Are you my daddy? Or is it you? No, no, not
you. Yes, you. You're my daddy.
Oh. Forrest Winter hasn't shown up yet.
Or hasn't he?
Has he now? Or has he hasn't? No. Well, where the hell is he? Where is the man of the hour? Where is he now? Where is he now? Where is he?
You know what happened to me. Ah,
please stop.
Stop denying it, Sebastian. You know what they did to Daddy. Ah.
You see what you did? You're too much. You're trying to kill me. I don't want to play with you no more. I don't want to play with you no more. I don't want to play with you no more. I don't want to. Oh, I like this show.
Let's get to know today's contestant, Sebastian Winthrop.
Hey, that's me.
Sebastian Winthrop. Now it says here you're only 8 years old.
A little young for this game, are you?
I'm 8, grown, big boy.
A mama's boy who never tires of wearing black for your pension in churches and cemeteries, who aspires to leave the house without hearing a eulogy nearby.
That's me.
Let's get down to business, little man. Are you ready to play?
Well, what's the game today? Is it gonna help me see my daddy? Is seeing my daddy my prize? Is my daddy my prize? Is my daddy? Is my daddy?
Little man, I understand you're suffering from a condition. Is that correct?
The growling. It won't stop.
It's not his stomach.
And what is it?
It's a malnourishment.
A mal what?
Little man, I invite you to play.
Play?
You'll find out how to stop the growling.
So I'm gonna see my daddy again? So seeing my daddy's my prize? Seeing my daddy's gonna help stop the growling? I'm gonna win.
You're gonna win, my big winner. My big winner, boy.
Oh, the wind drops a winner.
The wind drops are expiring.
All right. We can play. But it's my game. I ask the questions. And if I don't like the answers, watch out. People drop like flies around here. Got it? Good. Round one. Who was Forrest Winthrop? Winthrop, comma, Forrest. Who was Forrest Winthrop? Winthrop, comma, Forrest.
Tragedy interrupts an otherwise peaceful Memorial Day weekend. A Brooklyn teenager is dead after a shooting involving an NYPD officer around 3 o'clock this morning in Bed Stuy. The officer says he was responding to a call about a public disturbance when 19-year-old Forrest Winthrop was seen running through the streets. The incident happened on the border of Myrtle and Tompkins Avenue, where the unarmed teenager was shot multiple times.
Stop! Who was Forrest Winthrop? Winthrop, comma, Forrest.
Winthrop of old English origins, first derived from the English surname, or from a place possibly Winthrop in England, meaning wine's village.
Approximately 300 pounds. Skin that overdosed on melanin.
confirmed he could impregnate white women by just glaring at them. When examining the abdomen, a cornucopia of fried chicken, watermelon, and waffles came bursting at the seams and ruined the medical table. Hard and impressive in stature. When touched upon, a blast of aggressive noises came out like a cry, suppressed underwater. He had a 6-digit code on his neck, belonged to some correctional facility.
What about his brain?
Didn't have one. Must have lost it. Where his mind should have been was a box of pampers.
Pampers? My daddy didn't need no diapers. Diapers are for babies. He was grown. Big boy, ain't no babies around here.
Winthrop was rushed to Kings County Hospital, where he was immediately pronounced dead. The officer said he reacted upon discovering that the teenager was armed.
Shut up.
The coroner conducted a second search and did not find any weapons or illegal items on the teenager.
The officer has
not been seen since and is allegedly under investigation.
Shut up. Angry crowd.
Was Forrest Winthrop? Winthrop, comma, Forrest. Who was Forrest Winthrop? Winthrop, comma, Forrest. Who was Forrest Winthrop? Winthrop, comma, Forrest. No, no, no. My daddy was no thing. He was a man, big boy like me. I won? Damn right I won. Where did I win? I'll take it. Hey, I'll take it. I think I like this game. Round two. Why are you so fixated on a dead nigga who abandoned you? Never mind. Pass, I don't like this round.
You ask!
Because it's what I'm asked all the time. Because the question's ringing in my head like I hate this place!
Let's pathologize abandonment and repress your sexuality. Could it be? Could you be?
A latent homosexual.
Faggot.
With Electra's attraction for a parent of the same sex, I've seen it before. A fatherless state devolves into a primitive hunger to resolve the unresolved. Psycho. Sexual. Drama. But he's missing our strong, masculine figures in his life. Surrogate fathers. Men to show him how to be a man. That'd be the antidote.
Let's pathologize abandonment and cause neurological damage!
He got ADD! He got ADHD!
Oh no!
He got OCD! He got Goo Goo Gaga Bubba
Doo!
He's antisocial! He's a baby sociopath! He's
multi-pack. Is there a name brand? Is there a brand for pulp folks?
Is it covered by my medical provider? Is it covered by Obamacare? Does Obamacare?
What if I lose more people in my life? My mama, my grandmoms, my uncle? What if I lose my sense of taste, my sense of smell, my sight? What if my abandonment extends me all my lifetime and comes from a well with no known source?
There ain't no antidote. Why do I cry so much?
Because you're sad and angry.
Yes, I'm sad. And I'm angry.
Care, I can look up. Sebastian!
How did you know?
Tears unlock a double prize.
Two prizes? I get two prizes? I've never stopped crying. Now, but I know that. What's my prize? I'll take it. And I'll take it. Round three. We're getting close. I can feel my You know, sometimes when I take a breath, the air doesn't stop at the bottom. It sinks down, down into a deep place. Is that where the ground comes from?
It's not your stomach!
You said that already!
You inherited it!
Of who? You know what? This is stupid. You're stupid. Your information, I'm 8, bro. Big boy. So I miss my daddy, that's all. I just want the groundless.
Oh, little man, you want to know about things you don't already know.
Just want the growling to stop.
You don't know how to make it stop?
Think I do?
I can help. But I'll have to run the game for now. It's the only way!
Okay. But be gentle. I don't want to cry anymore. Not unless I get 3 prizes.
Now, historically, this game is best played while lying down, so lie down. In fact, get used to being belly up. Where did your parents do the nasty when they made you?
In a subway car, Stillwell Avenue. Bitch, please. As if I would ever have sex in a moving vehicle or a public place. You and Forrest Fox everywhere. How else did you get pregnant?
Nah, girl, that's a fair point.
I don't know, I just...
Trash time!
Sorry, ask me enough when I get it this time!
After your mama tucks you in that night, hits the lights and goes, nighty-nighty! Do you ever like to spank your monkey?
All the time.
Sebastian!
But I like it!
And when you beat the meat, who's running through your mind? Come on, little man.
My daddy was gonna be a football star. The richest thing to come out of here since Jay-Z. My daddy was gonna buy us a house in a suburban neighborhood. My daddy was gonna hold me tight. My daddy was gonna whisper in my ear, you don't know how much I missed you today. My daddy was gonna, my daddy was gonna, my daddy was gonna, my daddy, my daddy, my daddy, my daddy.
Is it you?
No.
Who killed your dad? Resolution Nation, baby.